Good morning. Hey, everybody. Super excited to see you today. It's Monday, and we are talking Steam Explorer's sound issue. It's week two of this really fun book, and I want to show you some sound. Now, that sounds funny, right? Seeing sound? But the cool thing about sound is not only do you hear it, but you can actually visualize sound because you can create some devices that show how sound waves work. And so this week's seeing sound issue is all about that. So we have two fun projects and a super fun quick print printable this week. First up, we're gonna be making our tonoscope out of recyclables. And then you're gonna be visualizing some sound waves with straws. It's really cool. And then before we jump into all that and how to make it and things like that, I just want to remind you what this week's quick print activity is. It's our color by coding, and it's a really fun monster DJ this week. I love this one. So definitely be sure to print this and check it out. So hope you and the kids are, and if you kids are hanging out with me today too, hope everyone is having fun with these hands-on projects all about STEAM, science, tech, engineering, art, and math through STEAM Explorers. And let's get started and talk about sound, actually. So we talked about it. So sound is just a vibration. It is a vibration, and it's a wave. Sound waves travel through the air, they travel through water, they travel through solids. You can hear a clink, 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 clink. It's a little bit more impressive with some metal like scissors. Sound waves travel through any type of matter. And if you can picture sound waves, let's say you have a bucket full of ping pong balls, and I should have brought some because it would have been really fun. What happens when a sound wave and that vibration moves through matter? It hits a molecule. Pretend this is an air molecule, a gas molecule like air, like oxygen, things like that. Okay, when it hits, the vibration hits the molecule, watch, it moves, right? But if there's another molecule next to it, whoa, that molecule might go flying. No, what happens is the vibrations pass from molecule to molecule to molecule, and then they move through that matter, like a gas, a liquid, a solid. And what you'll find is actually that in these projects, you can see these vibrations move and you can visualize the patterns that they make. So and then we can talk a little bit too, those vibrations head into your ear. And what ends up happening there is they send these vibrations into some bones inside your ear. They get funneled in. And I'll talk a little bit more about it next week as we talk about amplifying our ears and how animals with big ears get to do that. But we'll talk more next week. But this week is all about seeing these vibrations. So, project number one, let's get that out. Paper, straw, sound waves. Oh, I said paper. Paper straws, yes, absolute favorite steam supply. Better for the earth than plastic straws. They can be used in so many cool ways. You can punch holes in them and make them into a building kit. You can use them to make pinwheels. You can do all sorts of things. And you can use them, let me pick up my sound wave here. Very cool. You can use them to visualize DNA. Does this remind you of DNA? You can make a double helix, or you can make a sound wave, and you can learn the patterns that waves make. Up, down, that sine wave. So for this, I'm gonna just show you really quick. I'm gonna flip my camera down, and I'm gonna show you how I make that and the quick tools, but then we're gonna get into the fun stuff. We're gonna get into the tonoscope, which is really the cool project for this week, and it's the must-try project for the sound issue, okay? Definitely give this one a try. All right, hold on one second. Tip those down. And you can, as my camera
is giving me trouble today. Okay, hold on. One second. Okay, we are going to have to move this way. Extra fun setup today. Okay. Yep, my table. And there we go. Now we got it. Okay, let's talk paper straws. Let's talk sound waves. Okay, so the really quick and easy project, let me rephrase that. It's not that quick, because you need about 45 straws. But the way you make this cool thing, and what's really cool about it, is you can see vibrations move through the sound waves. You can twist it, so like, and talk about frequency of sound, things like that. But the way you make it, you want a tape measure, and you need about 4 feet, okay? Oh, this is backwards. Hold on one sec. Let me cut that off. There, now we're better. Okay, you're gonna lay out your tape measure for about 4 feet. Pretend this says 4 feet on here. Then you're gonna take a piece of masking tape that is 4 feet long. You're just gonna roll it out like that, okay? And then you're gonna take one end, you're gonna fold that down, and you're gonna touch that on the floor. This works really well as a project on the floor, okay? But if you fold the ends down, they hold this tape on the floor, okay? And then you're just gonna go like that. Then you're gonna grab your straws, and you have your tape measure next to you, and you're gonna center them over the tape, just like this. And then you're gonna push down like that over it, okay? And then you're gonna keep going with lots of straws, about 1 inch apart, okay? Try to line them up as good as you can. It doesn't have to be perfect. Then you keep going like this with a few more straws. Now, I'm gonna cheat, and I'm gonna just show how you would do this if you had. Now, keep doing this for about 4 feet, leaving a couple of inches on each end, okay? Then you're gonna take another piece of tape, and you're gonna cover this one, and you're gonna touch right between. So you, and then smooth it down so that you have sort of this, you can kind of see how it's stuck together just like that. And once you get that whole long wave together, then you can make cool patterns with this, right? Okay, and that's a fun way. It's a great thing in a group. You can make these as long as you want. I did 4 feet. It showed a few different waves, multiple wavelengths in this. If you had a classroom, you could honestly do this all the way across the classroom, and it would be so cool to watch the vibrations move across your straw sound waves. Okay, all right, let's put that away and get to the really fun stuff. This is our tonoscope, which is kind of wonky. But here's what a tonoscope does. Okay, for the tonoscope, you are going to need, actually, let me show you what it does first. So what a tonoscope does, is when you put some salt on it, okay, you put a little salt on this balloon membrane on the top, and then you're gonna make a sound inside, just like this, okay? And watch. Okay, let me get down here, let me hold this. You can see the pattern of the salt. Now, the cool thing about this is you get to play around. Oh, by the way, you might want a tray under this or somewhere you can sweep up, because salt does get a little bit all over for this. What you'll notice is that different frequencies of sound make different patterns on your tonoscope. Okay, so I'm gonna just put this to the side here so that I can show you how to make one, okay? Just like this. Alrighty. So for this, don't forget you got your very cool instructions. Every project has your supply list. For this, you need 2 of these, including the one that I threw across the room when I was playing pretend molecules. You need 2 paper towel rolls. You need a plastic food container. like a yogurt. This is a cottage cheese, butter, things like that. You need one of those. You need a marker, something that will mark on this. You need a box cutter. Adults only, please, on this. These are super sharp, so I want to make sure you're being safe. You need a balloon. Oh, there went my pile of salt. Okay. You need a balloon. 12 inches is about what you need to cover a container this size. Smaller than that, you're going to have a hard time stretching. You actually want it super taut, so the 12 inches is actually hard to stretch even like that. Okay, so you got your balloons. You need a rubber band, because the rubber band's going to hold that balloon down. You need some scissors, masking tape, and of course, you need some salt. So you got your bowl of salt here. Okay, so let's get building. So the very first thing you're going to do on this is grab one of your rolls and the side of your yogurt container, okay? And you're just going to make kind of a imperfect, don't stress if it's not exact, circle around your roll. Okay, just to mark about the size of the hole that you want for this. The cool thing about this is if it's not perfect, don't stress, because you get to use tape to cover it up. Okay, now taking your box cutter, safety first. Okay, make sure your fingers are not inside the container. You can hold the edge, but we don't want you to go through the plastic and into a hand and cut, okay? All right, so I like to hold it like this a little bit. Then you're gonna cut this piece of plastic out, because this is where, and again, as I said, oh, this one, oh, I need a new blade, I think. If you've ever learned this one, dull blades are actually more dangerous than sharp blades because you have to put more force and you're more likely to cut yourself. But in general, keep it safety first. So then, okay, we're cutting, oops, all the way through. Don't worry, you can cover anything up with tape. Okay, sometimes it helps to start at a different spot and move along. Okay, I probably should have done this off camera for you, because this might be a little boring to watch, right? Huh? You're watching me struggle with a dull box cutter. Okay, so I got a little bit more plastic, and I said don't leave your fingers in, but it can help to hold up the pieces you've already cut. Okay, here we go. Almost there. All right, woo, we did it. Okay, so you're gonna cut that out, and you're gonna close your box cutter, put it away, out of kid's reach, etc. Now, you are going to double check and make sure that your paper roll, your first paper roll, fits in there, okay? Then, what you're gonna do is you have to make this part. See, we have a little bit of a, one roll goes in here, and then one comes up in an angle, so it's easy for you to do your sound in. But to make that happen, you're gonna cut a half circle out of one of these. I'm gonna show you how to do this. You're just gonna take this, and again, these don't have to be perfect. Oh, helps if I get this on screen for you, huh? Okay. Cut that up. Now you have a nice, exactly. Okay, put this in. Next step, grab your masking tape. Make sure that this opening right here is like this so that you can stick your second roll inside. You see that? Okay, so now you've stuck your parts together. Then you need your masking tape. And all you're doing is making these joints hold together. So it really, you just don't want a ton of air to escape, because the more air you have when you're sound, the better this will go through your tonoscope. And okay, then you want to go like this. This one's a little bit harder because you're going on a round shape, so it helps to have as I tear a very long piece, it helps to have shorter pieces. And then what you're just going to go is like short piece around, short piece around. You can also use duct tape if you want. Duct tape is a little stickier and harder to remove if you have a mishap of where you put it, but it is more secure. So if you're gonna keep this for a little while, be sure to throw on some duct tape. Okay. All right. So now what you have is a very messy, don't stress, this is about mess, right? Oh wait, I like that, it rhymes. Okay, so you have your seams here. Now, your last step for this, so put this right here. One thing I found is if you put the joint inside your tape, it sits up a little bit better. Now, grab one of your balloons, give it a stretch, and then you're gonna cut the neck part of this off. You're just gonna go like this, okay? And then you wanna see the absolute hardest part of this whole project is to just stretch this over your yogurt container, okay? And so pull one side. Oh, and then it's gonna roll, so bear with me. Bigger hands help. This is might be one for the adults to get this on, okay? Just like that. So now I got my balloon on. Then take your rubber band and put it over like this. This is just gonna keep the balloon from rolling up, okay? Just like that. Okay, now you have a working tonoscope. Wanna see it work? Okay, let's hope this one works just as well as the last one, okay? So you can put some salt on it. Start with a little bit. What you'll notice is that if you have too much, it doesn't really work very well. It's too heavy. If you don't have enough, you don't get good patterns. So you just play with the amount here. Now, what's happening is as you make your humming noise, whatever sound into the end, those sound vibrations are traveling through the length of the paper towel roll and into the yogurt cup. And then because the balloon is flexible, those vibrations make the salt on top of it move. So let's give this one, it helps to hold it. Hold on. And then you should play around. So with the tonoscope, I've included a lab worksheet too. So it's really fun to draw the different patterns that you get. And you know what's really cool about the tonoscopes too is these designs that vibrations make, hold on one second, are called, drop my piece of paper, my notes here. So these patterns that you'll make on your tonoscope, they're called Chladni patterns, and they're named after the German physicist. I've got all this in here. Be sure to always check out what's the steam behind it, right? A German physicist and musician named Ernst Chladni, who is considered the father of acoustics. And so these patterns that you make based on the different frequencies, low notes, high notes, things like that, the different volumes, those patterns are named after him. So. And there you go. There is your fun with seeing sound this week. I hope you loved playing with the tonoscope, and we will see you next week for Hearing Nature. Take care. Bye.